Hello traders, in this video we will cover the gold. This is the video we actually posted in our live trading group with our students. And in this video we set and we showed what is our plan on gold and what we are looking for here. So we said we are looking for possible breakout to the upside and continuation on possible structure change to the upside, and this was last week. Now we'll go over the charts and how this plan actually play out on the gold. So on the gold, if I check the charts and show you the charts right now on the gold, this is a daily time frame and we had bullish structure. So in the bullish structure, market was creating higher highs, higher lows, and on this retracement to the downside we had potential swing low to be formed here. So we said we are looking for possible continuation to target the buy side liquidity, the previous highs. And if you go to the 4 hourly time frame, this is the chart we showed before in our live trading group here. So in this case, at this point of time, we had a bearish structure. Market formed a double bottom here, and we said we are looking for possible breakout to the upside, and then we can look for possible 4 hourly or 1 hourly trading opportunities on this retest to trade a possible continuation to the previous highs, to target this buy side liquidity. So if we go over the charts right now, this is the 4 hourly time frame we showed before in our trading group. So at this point of time, if you remember, we had this double bottom down there, we had this swing high here, and we said we are looking for possible breakout, retest of this level, and then we can look for 4 hourly or 1 hourly opportunities to target the buy side liquidity, the previous highs at a 1980 level. So as you can see here on the 4 hourly, we had this bearish structure, we had double bottom, and as the market broke to the upside through this level, we said we are looking for possible fair value gaps and possible trading opportunities in the discount areas on the 4 hourly or 1 hourly chart. So on the breakout to the upside on the 4 hourly, we actually didn't have anything worth trading, to be honest here, but we actually used and we checked the 1 hourly time frame. So on the 4 hourly time frame, we saw the market broke to the upside, and on the breakout to the upside, the first trading opportunities were actually here in the early Asian session and during the Australian session, and this is the point of time where we actually don't trade, of course. So as you can see, later on through the over the day on the 26th July, so this was on Wednesday, this is the Wednesday market open, during the night price was retesting this level, the previous high which turned into the support here, and in the London trading session we had nice breakout to the upside. So market actually broke through these levels in the overnight trading session, and on the breakout to the upside, what we noticed on the 1 hour time frame was also this breakout to the upside with a nice fair value gap here. As you can see, on the breakout to the upside we had fair value gap between first, second and third candle. So this is the area, this is the zone we said we want to be aware of, and we want to look for potential reaction at it. So as you can see, as the market broke from this swing low to the upside, to the swing high, and moved 120 pips to the upside, we said we are looking for possible retracement back to the discount area. So discount area means that if you draw your Fibonacci from swing low to the swing high and the market retrace 50% or more and we see reaction, then of course this is the zone we want to look for potential trading opportunities. So what do we notice here? As the market retraced back to this fair value gap zone, and we got nice reaction with nice spike and also bullish candle confirmed. That means that that's perfect spot to look for our trading opportunities here. So where the market bounced from, it bounced also exactly with this fair value gap combination and discount area. It also bounced exactly in this area in combination with previous highs. So previous highs resistance turned into the support, and as you can see, we had nice entry here at 1968 level during the New York session and London trading session, and we entered it here. We put the stop loss below the structure 70, as you can see, in this case, so in this case below the lows, and we can of course target 1-to-1 or 1-to-2 in terms of risk and reward ratio. So if you risk 1%, then you could get 1 up to 2%, and if you risk 2%, then of course you could get 2 up to 4% on this trade, on this nice trading opportunities on gold, where we targeted this high and previous buy side liquidity up here. So that's how you can look for trading opportunities when you have clear direction and clear structure on the daily, 4-hourly, 1-hourly chart. So yes, that's how you can look for trading opportunities in your trading business. So thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, just comment below or send me an email. So take care, and we catch up soon.